Oh, it's you.
You didn't hear me calling here?
No, wait. I forget something in the office. Let me go back for it.
Wait, Danny. Let me go back with you now.
It's all right. I know the way.
Pop me a vex or something.
Why you don't leave me alone?
Just so what happened?
Look now, woman. You didn't say I want to be alone?
Better plans with you.
Danny, what are we playing for?
Papa George, let me make it $1.
Gosh, you want to dry me up? Since you walk in, you only call in big stakes.
For exactly. Give me one.
Let me see. Take one.
Ah, Papa George, you dig your own grave.
Danny boy.
Night, me well.
You forget you're supposed to come by me for your tea.
Still early, man. I just start up a game here with Papa George.
Count me in that.
We don't start.
Shut your old mouth. Deal me in.
Oh, gosh, I tell you, I done deal already.
Oh-ho, because you're holding a set of drums. Deuce and Jack, Queen, you don't want to start over, although I ask you to start over.
All right, I'm going to start over. Who to deal?
What we playing?
All fours.
I do like to play three and all fours. Then you play Romy.
All right, Romy.
First Jack deal.
Nah, man, that has take too long. I can't deal.
Papa George said it.
What are we playing for this time?
Same stakes, $1.
Cracks. I thought all we'll play for water. Papa George, put a dollar there for me. I'll go pay you back.
Oh, gosh, Mabel, I ain't...
What happened? You think it hard to put one little squingy dollar there for me? I'll go pay you back your money. I want to eat it, you know.
All right. Look it.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, Tina.
Night, Tina.
I'm up here on the cars now.
Danny, somebody out in the road asking to talk to you.
There are two legs.
She didn't want to come.
She? Who's that boy?
She said to tell you it's Carol.
She, look. Tell she ain't see me.
But I tell her you're here already.
I don't care. Tell she I'm not here. Tell she is sleeping or sick or some kind of thing.
But Danny, how you could do the girl that?
Mabel, you don't know. So don't talk. Who to play?
I pong to talk, man. All a man like a treat woman too bad. I don't like the girl. But since she come quite up here to see her, at least you could go and see she.
All right. Only don't play until I come back, you know. So I will need the stakes to make sure.
Yes, Daddy. Mommy lost interest in everything. She doesn't chat for hours on the phone with her friends. She doesn't look at the television series she used to follow, like Dallas, Dynasty, and Falcon Crest. Something is wrong. She is depressed.
You really think so?
Oh, yes. Mommy remains still and just stare into space as if her mind is far away. You should come and see her, Daddy. She really needs you.
I don't care.
Come tonight, Daddy, please.
Let me see. It's kind of difficult.
You can't forget that girl for one night?
Surely.
Sorry, Daddy. I know I shouldn't meddle in your business, but Mommy would be happy to see you. That is why I came, Daddy. You came to me once because she needed me. Now I come to you because she needs you too.
All right. You win. I'll be there just after 7, okay?
Thanks, Daddy. I'll look out for you.
Think Brutus will remember me?
He too is grieving for you. Well, I must go now.
Okay, Shirley. Wait a minute. Take this and buy yourself a few things. That's my messenger.
I'll see you then. Bye.
I would like you to meet him.
Your messenger? For what?
Just wait. Come in.
Morning, sir. Shirley.
Danny?
Imagine you two know each other.
Daddy, did you arrange this?
Not at all. Danny's working for me now and he's most efficient.
Mr. Wells,
Danny, can you just hold on here for me a while? Just remember, I have to see Mr. Goodman about an urgent matter.
Daddy, don't forget tonight. I'll see you then.
Shirley, could you just hold on for me a minute? I have to tell you something.
But Daddy, I thought we were...
Darling, just sit and wait for me, okay?
All right.
You want to read the papers?
All right.
Please let me come to the office.
No.
Shirley, as you see, I'm working now.
Yes, congratulations.
Shirley, when we was living together...
Excuse me, please.
Wait, Shirley, please.
I think I'll wait outside my father's office.
You're going to make it look bad as if I'm listening here.
But that's exactly what you're doing.
Me?
Yes, you. I'll wait outside the door.
No, I'll wait outside then. You make me lose my job.
And I don't want that to happen.
Shirley, just sit down, please.
All right.
Shirley, I'm saving money now.
That's good.
Imagine, I have money in the bank. Every fortnight, I put in a little caca there.
Uh-huh.
Next year, carnival, I play in one big mass with all my money. People hold their head and ball. You see me putting the papers on the television.
I thought you say you're saving money.
Yes, but for a purpose, to play mass.
I thought you had better sense than that.
Shirley, when we was living together...
Excuse me, please, I think I'll wait
out. Shirley, sorry. I get your message loud and clear. I see you have to watch my language when I'm talking to you.
Not only your language.
Myself?
You're sure right.
Shirley, if I tell you something, you won't believe me.
Even if I believe, I couldn't care two hoots.
Shirley, I see your face everywhere. During the day, I see your face everywhere I go. I see a girl walking down the road, and she reminds me of you. At nights, I lie in bed, and I dream of you.
You could waste your dreams.
Shirley, you mean there's no chance for me again?
He said it.
Shirley, you have somebody else?
No.
Shirley, but you must have a boyfriend.
There's nothing like must. But why worry about me anyway? You's a man with plenty girlfriends. You yourself say once, it is as easy for you to get a girlfriend as for you to snap your fingers.
Shirley, why do you think your father left us alone?
It couldn't be for us to make up, because I burned that bridge behind me. Maybe it is for us to cuss up each other again. Look, it's time I get out of here. I'd ring my father and tell him I couldn't wait any longer. Goodbye, Mr. King.
Bye, Shirley.
Say hello to the stinkers in Calabash Alley.
Shirley!